In this video, we will introduce some troubleshooting methods for virtual machine failed to join our domain. We can troubleshoot according to the following steps when the virtual machine fails to join our domain. Step 1, go to VDI Options Authentication LDAP Server. Check whether the VDC can normally obtain the base DN of the LDAP server. After login VDC Management Platform, go to VDI Options Authentication LDAP Server. Click Base DN will display the organizational structure of the entire ad domain. In this case, the communication between the ad domain and the VDC is normal. If the VDC cannot normally obtain the organizational structure of the ad domain, we need to check whether the administrator's authority is sufficient. Step 2, go to VDI Options Resources. Check if the resource is associated with the corresponding ad domain. Builtist is the resource of test environment. Click Resource Name Builtist, and then click Domain and SSO. Click Test Connectivity to confirm whether this resource connected to the ad domain successfully. If the VDC is connected to the ad domain normally, the VDC will prompt connecting to ad domain successfully. When Join VM to Ad Domain is ticked, after the VDI user login, the computer will automatically join the ad domain. If the VDC cannot connect to the ad domain, we need to check the connectivity of port 389 between the VDC and the ad domain. In some special scenarios, the configurations on the VDC are correct. However, the virtual machine still cannot auto-join the ad domain normally. Step 3, check if the virtual machine can join the domain manually. The method of manually joining the domain is the same as the way the physical PC joins the domain, so we will not introduce it here. If the VM cannot join the domain manually, we need the ad domain administrator to check whether the ad domain environment is misconfigured. Step 4, check whether the DNS configuration of the virtual machine is correct. The ad domain name of WeTested is srv.test. Use the ping command of Windows to confirm whether the virtual machine can normally parse the ad domain. The IP of the ad domain can be displayed normally in the ping result, which means the DNS configuration is correct. In other cases, we need to ensure that the DNS of the virtual machine can properly resolve the ad domain name. Step 5, : check whether the agent service is normal. When the agent service is abnormal, VDC will prompt waiting for agent to connect. The normal agent status is a necessary condition for the virtual machine to join our domain. Step 6, analyze logs related to virtual machine joining the ad domain. When the virtual machine fails to join the domain, we need to use the local administrator account of Windows to enter the system. On Windows, launch run program and enter %d%/logs to open the log directory. We need to focus on whether there is error or error code in the vdnetadom.log. Here we can see the obvious error code. Login VDC, go to Maintenance Troubleshooting Logs, search solutions according to logs error code. In the details of the error code, we can see impact on the system, possible cause and processing steps. The possible cause is the domain does not exist or the domain name has been occupied. When the DNS configured in the virtual machine cannot resolve the ad domain name normally, the virtual machine thinks that the domain does not exist. In this case, after we reconfigure DNS, the virtual machine can join the domain normally. If the vdnetdom.log log is analyzed, the problem cannot be solved. We can use the same method to analyze log on ui.log. In the end of this tutorial, we have learned on how to check the basic configuration of VM joining ad domain, how to test the connectivity between VDC and ad domain, how to analyze related logs of VM joining domain.